एवरीवन, दिस इज आरती जिंदल एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इफ यू आर न्यू टू माय चैनल, काइंडली सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड हिट द बेल आइकन टू गेट द रीसेंट अपडेट्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट अबाउट आवर टॉपिक, दैट इज जेंडर, व्हिच कम्स अंडर नाउन। सो व्हाटएवर नाउन्स दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, दीज नाउन्स आर कंसिडर्ड अंडर सम डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ जेंडर्स। सो देर आर मेनली फोर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ जेंडर। फर्स्ट इज मैस्कुलिन जेंडर, सेकेंड इज फेमिनिन जेंडर, थर्ड इज कॉमन जेंडर एंड फोर्थ इज न्यूट्रल जेंडर। सो मैस्कुलिन जेंडर इज ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज पुल्लिंग इन हिंदी, फेमिनिन जेंडर इज टर्म्ड एज स्त्रीलिंग इन हिंदी, कॉमन जेंडर इज टर्म्ड एज उभयलिंग इन हिंदी एंड न्यूट्रल जेंडर इज टर्म्ड एज नपुंसकलिंग इन हिंदी। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट डिस्कसिंग ऑल दीज टाइप्स ऑफ जेंडर्स वन बाय वन। सो द फर्स्ट इज मैस्कुलिन जेंडर, दैट इज पुल्लिंग, अ नाउन दैट रेफर्स टू अ मेल or to an object classified as male, and we use pronoun he for this gender. So whenever we are talking about a noun that refers to a male, that refers to a strength, right? So that particular noun will be considered under masculine gender, right? So let us discuss this with the help of examples: boy, lion, man, actor. These are some examples which refers to a male. So that's why these type of examples, these type of nouns will come under masculine gender. Now let us understand some more example: the sun, time, summer, winter, ocean. These are some examples that shows us about the strength, right? So that's why we consider these types of nouns in masculine gender. Now let us move further to the second type of gender, that is feminine gender, that we call streeling in Hindi. So a noun that refers to a female or to a object remarkable for beauty, gentleness and gracefulness, and we use the pronoun she for feminine gender. So whatever noun that we are talking about, if that noun refers to a female, right? If it's a living being, so if we are talking about a female, that noun will come under feminine gender. And if we are talking about an object that shows us about its beauty, gentleness and gracefulness, then we'll consider that noun as feminine gender. So the examples are girl, lioness, sister, actress. These are the examples of noun that refers to a female, right? So let us discuss some more examples. These are the objects, that is the moon, spring, mercy, nature, liberty. These are some of the objects that shows us about the beauty, the gentleness and gracefulness, right? Because as we can see, in summer season we feel immense hot, in winter season we can feel immense cold. So that's why we consider summer season and winter season in masculine gender, and spring being the very gentle season, because each of us, every one of us like this season. So that's why this season comes under feminine gender. Now let us move further to the next type of gender, that is common gender. Now a noun that refers to a male or a female, right? So that is common, right? That is common for male and female both, right? So example is friend. So a friend can be a male or it can be a female also. Similarly, teacher. So the teacher can be male or a female also. Similarly, student, child, neighbor. These are some of the examples that comes under common gender. Now friends, let us come to the last type of gender, that is neuter gender, right? A noun that refers to a lifeless object. So if we are talking about any non-living thing, any non-living object, then we can consider that type of noun in neuter gender. So some examples are book, stone, paper, chair, tree. So these all are lifeless objects. So these type of objects will come under neuter gender. And always we use the pronoun it for neuter gender. Right? So, there is one more important thing that comes under neuter gender, and that is collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. These type of nouns always comes under neuter gender. So, we have already discussed in our previous videos about what are the collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. So, these three types of nouns always comes under neuter gender. Similarly, there is one more important point, that is small babies or infants, small animals always comes under neuter gender. So, these are two important things that we need to remember every time when we are talking about genders, right? So, that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much if you like my video. If you like my video, kindly hit the like button. If you want to comment something, if you want to share something with me, then surely you can comment and subscribe my channel to get the recent updates. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.